more of these sprats on stakes. Get the feeling someone doesn't like sprats. I'm wondering who set all that stuff up. Over there. Oh. It's one way in, apparently. Let's go this way. Getting close to some of these. Oh, somewhat close. These phonographs? Oh, that's just that. Okay. That's a small building compared to what's coming up. Hard. How dare you? How dare you bar my way? A long road around? Office of Creative Incubation. Okay. Let's check this out first. Canid Sparkler? I'm not sure why it's called a sparkler. Wait, this is down. Oh. The office is down there, or one of them. And then what's this? Just something?
It is endlessly fascinating to me that all of existence is simply atoms, molecules, and chemical reactions, which in turn create and govern our bodies, minds, and emotions. And yet somehow, we still believe we are in control.
Yeah. Secret hideout. Sealed. Well, let's unseal it. Archibald Excelsior, secret society of super science sidekicks? Halt! The passage is exclusive to members of the Secret Society of Super Science Sidekicks. To gain access to this sacred sanctum, someone really loves alliteration, you must prove you are a true and worthy fan of the inimitable, inestimable, incomparable Ace Exterminator Archibald Excelsior. Interested? Find us at the following locations and demonstrate your worth. By the Marvelous Mustache of Excelsior, Maurice Walton, SMC Observatory, Virgil Sharp, Gorgon Mines, Birdie Sharp, HIA Maintenance Entrance, and Eustace Kim, Waste Processing Ravine. I wonder if we can get into it. It doesn't look like we can get into there, at least not yet. A dialogue between dead men. Find the clue. Synthesis of manufactory observatory. Gorgon Mines waste processing. To those who came after. Who come after. From Walton M. 2. Number S5. Hideout. Gorgon's gone to hell, and we don't expect it to come back, so the Secret Society of Super Science Sidekicks, also known as S5, because there's five S's, are shipping out while there's still ships to catch, and we're leaving our replica pet, P-E-T, behind. I can't say it's what we wanted, not after all the crap we churned through to make it, but it's what our fearless leader, the inimitable Archibald Excelsior, would have asked of us. Now, if you're reading this, that means you're a scavenger. Scavenging takes daring, gumption, and a dash of rank, reckless stupidity. Just the kind of qualities Archibald's been known to prize, and just the kind of person worthy of our PET, the best and only prototype pest extermination truncheon. That's what that stands for. In all of Halcyon. If you want it, friend, it's yours. All you gotta do is pass our test and prove yourself a true fan of Archibald Excelsior, Ace Exterminator. Lost speed and good luck by the marvelous mustache of Excelsior Maurice. Okay. Well, we can't get in there yet. Is this that secret, not secret, but little side passage we saw before? No, this goes somewhere else? Well, I'm not even sure. Let's just check it out. For that's the Office of Creative Incubation itself. Interesting. Is that? I don't know if we've been over here or not. Second mate, Rex. First mate, Raquel. Friendly, maybe? Not showing up with the red danger.
Is that a fossilized giant pterosaur? Magnificent.
Where? I mean, I could actually see it on the map. Oh, that. Oh, yeah. I don't know if they come that big. I don't know what that is. But you might be right. It's a llama?
I say you're wrong.
I don't think that's a llama.
Llama?
Llama!
You guys all right?
Have you ever seen a finer specimen of a llama before?
That is not a llama.
I'm telling you, this isn't the rock. We need to turn back.
This is the spot. Now keep your eyes peeled. The dead drop is at the foot of the alpaca, he said. And this is the alpaca.
Well, now it's an alpaca.
Llama.
What was that?
It's a llama we're after, sir. Not an alpaca. And this is neither.
Llama, alpaca, same thing.
Not really.
Llama.
They aren't the same at all, sir. Believe it or not.
Enough. We've got company. Out with it, then. Who are you?
Are you the survivors from that crashed ship by the landing pad?
I'm the captain of that crashed vessel, to be perfectly accurate.
Why start now?
What was that, first mate?
Just talking to myself again, sir.
We're on the hunt for a package. It's supposed to be at the foot of this handsome-looking, alpaca-shaped rock.
Llama?
Does this guy say anything else? Listen quietly?
This handsome-looking, llama-shaped rock. But the goods aren't here. Must have been stolen.
Mister, I don't mean to tell you your business, but this here's a fossilized monster skeleton. Just about the coolest one I ever seen, too.
She's right.
Obviously not an expert on geology, paleontology, or Earth species. Or much else.
This is not a rock shaped like a llama. This is a fossil shaped like a fossil. Captain.
Could it be the fossil of a llama?
I highly doubt that. Can you believe this guy?
No, I can't. The guy's obviously never seen a llama, no knows anything about it. You're right about one thing. This is definitely a fossil.
Thank you.
Hey, I do the talking around here. This is the right spot. I know it in my gut. But there's no package, and now my crew is insubordinate.
I'm pretty sure you're searching in the wrong place, sir.
Well, this is the only alpaca-shaped rock I've seen for miles, so let's agree to disagree.
Llama!
Llama. Sorry about my second mate. Ever since the crash, I can't squeeze a word of sense out of him.
Can't squeeze much sense out of you either, but you do say more than one word. What's the story with the package?
My crew and I are in the, parcel delivery trade. Our client is waiting on a delivery of special medicine, and this asteroid is the handoff point.
He means drugs. It's a specialty cocktail of adrenotime, pep pills, and dervish mist that our client takes to get out of bed every morning.
So you're drug dealers.
Llama.
Speak for yourself, llama boy. I'm getting out of this business as soon as we're done here.
Only problem is, the damn parcel isn't where it's supposed to be. Whoever heard of a llama-shaped rock, anyway? I mean, what are the odds?
Well, I could help you find the package, and I'm pretty sure I won't find it anywhere near here.
That won't be necessary. I have everything under control.
Sure you do.
Could have fooled me.
First mate, this is a llama, and that's an order. Now find me that package. It's around here somewhere.
You can't...
Hey, hear me out. You and I both know this isn't a llama.
You can't order something to be a llama. You can't change reality. How do you... Your captain needs to get his eyes checked.
Not to mention his ego, his judgment, and his spine.
What? You gotta start somewhere.
If you backtrack and take the right-hand fork, I could have sworn I saw the rock there already. Captain wouldn't let us stop because the beak wasn't sharp enough to be a llama.
Beak? So?
So? He's my captain. I'm supposed to trust him with my life, but he doesn't know a llama from a toucan. He won't even let us turn around because he's dug his heels into this fossil story. His pride is all tangled up in it. We're not getting off Gorgon without that package. If you can find the llama and the goods, you can have my cut of the take. I don't care. I just want out of here.
What are you willing to give up for... Why are you willing to give up your payment for the job?
I lost a lot of friends in that crash. All I got left are my idiot captain and a guy who can't stop saying llama. This isn't about money anymore. It's about survival and cutting my losses.
What the heck is the difference between a llama and an alpaca anyway?
Alpacas are cowards.
That it?
Never trust an alpaca. They're small, they're mean, and they'll stab you in the back first chance they get.
Good thing I'm searching for a llama then.
You're telling me. We'd be having a very different conversation if this were an alpaca-shaped rock.
Llama!
Don't let me down. That llama is my ticket out of here.
Move along, I say. We're conducting business.
Yeah, monkey business.
Any luck tracking down that llama? Technically, it's the package I'm after, but you get what I mean.
How did you get entangled in this llama business?
I don't even know anymore. We spend so long arguing about what is or isn't a llama that it's all a blur. Captain Babbage has a lot of strange contacts in the parcel delivery business. One of them must have a thing for llamas.
All right, I'll let you know if I find anything.
I'm counting on you. Don't let me down.
Llama. So this, you found the former hideout of the S5, a fan club dedicated to pulp comic hero Archibald Excelsior. To open the hideout store, you must find the sidekick's abandoned labs and search them for clues. Find the clue at the Gorgon Mines. Virgil Sharp left his clue. Eustace Kim left his clue somewhere in the waste processing ravine. Maurice Walton left his clue somewhere in the SMC observatory. And we find Bertie Sharp left her clue around human inquiry and auditing. Well, that's what HIA stands for. Maintenance entrance. Rendezvous at Llama. Yeah, Arthur C. Clarke. Rendezvous with Rama. Now, we've got an ode or a homage, whatever, to, Rendezvous at Llama. A crew of smugglers crashed their ship on Gorgon. They're here to retrieve a package by a rock shaped like a llama, but they can't seem to agree on what a llama looks like. First Mate Raquel insists she knows the location of this llama rock, and thus the location of the package. You would need to backtrack from the giant fossil, go down the canyon, and take the right-hand fork. Oh, quite far away. Ocular verifier. Terminal clue. Oh, but I've been over here. Jerome's flask? I missed that. We've been here. Okay, let's go back. I wonder if these baddies came back. So I missed something? It's up, though. Oh! Oh! I missed this? I walk right by this, we can go up. Okay. So I can't go in any of these doors, right? But we can go up here. Well, that's vital thing that I missed. Letters from Edgewater, 2 of 3. Dear Cousin Dan, Adrena time really leaves you wanting more, doesn't it? We got through the first batch fast, but lo and behold, Reed gave us more, in recognition of our exemplary work, ethic, and unwavering brand loyalty. How about that? Still no letter from you? I've been feeling a tad queasy lately, but I'm sure a little Adrena time is just what I need to shake it off. Write me back. How are the sunsets on Gorgon? Do you get sunsets? Huh. Oh, letters from Edgewater, 1 of 3. Dear Cousin Dan, Reed Thompson started doling out Adrena time to a select few of us, and guess who got his hands on the first batch? Isn't that the drug you're working on? I had my dosage this morning and worked straight through lunch. The guy who cleans salt tuna across from me is pulling his second shift, and now he's due for a 2-bit raise. You should see what he can do with a scaling knife. Don't forget to write back. Maybe get me to the Moon Man. Maybe get me the Moon Man's autograph after you've got a minute to spare. The Moon Man, yeah. How sad. I guess 3 of 3? Okay. Cousin Dan, Reed stopped giving out the stuff. Law damn it. If I can't get Adrena time from him, that makes you my only source. Don't you string me along. Can't work, can't sleep, can't even think straight. Give it over. Send me everything you've got now. Please. Also, are they hiring? Poor guy. Funny yet sad at the same time. Alright, so that's that. I can in these apartments, but that thing's up there, very close. The actual flask. Just check over here quick. Nothing. Except bit cartridges. Just restart recording here. Because I'm still having a little bit of stutter now and then. Apparently in there. And then there's another floor at least. There it is, engraved flask. The engraving reads, Jerome, cheers to the beginning of forever. Love, Leonora. It smells of decent whiskey, cheap cologne, and old cigarettes. Alright, we got it. We can return to her, Leonora. Found your own. Yeah, Leonora would be grateful if you return her husband's flask. She's back at the Sprat Shack on the second floor. Alright, before we do that, let's check up here. Can't go in any of these, but the last one. Champion toss ball stick.
This is my second month on Adrena time. It's like the color came back. Like I was tuned to the wrong band all this time, and now the static's gone. I'm finally clear-headed, focused. There's so much I'm excited to do. I feel like me again. Side effects? I guess I've noticed people staring at me a lot more lately. Hard to talk to them sometimes. Feels like they don't get it. Maybe they just don't trust it. Or maybe they don't trust me.
Yeah, Adrena time is messing people up real good. Or it was. Well, I can just... I was thinking about taking an elevator, but... I can just head back here.
Hopefully, following in Lucky's footsteps doesn't result in us sharing his fate.
You think this place we're headed will tell us more about Gorgon? I wonder what they got up to here.
Have I read this? Yeah. Returning to Leonora. How you doing? Do 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 do. Second floor. Hi. Guess what I got?
You find anything out there, you let me know. I'm ready to get off this rock.
Let me ask her this. What brings you to Gorgon?
Looking for something out there. Been paying Sublight to help me, but they haven't made much progress.
Sublight wouldn't turn over a rock unless there was salvage underneath it.
Well put. My husband and I worked on Gorgon during the good times. Jerome was on maintenance duty. I cleaned out test tubes till they sparkled.
Where were you during the bad times?
Getting the hell off Gorgon. In his final hours, Gorgon was a war zone. Violence broke out in the labs. The hills were full of marauders. You couldn't take a leisurely stroll without an armed escort. When the order came through to evacuate, non-essential personnel drew a lottery to see who would board the first wave of ships. Jerome won. I lost. As soon as I wasn't looking, Jerome switched our tickets and pushed me to the front of the line. I got to leave. Jerome stayed behind. I never saw him again.
That was very noble of him.
That Jerome. Always chose the right thing, even when it got him killed. This place is greedy. I took my Jerome, and it would have taken me too. I just want one thing back. His old hip flask. I gave it to him the day we signed our marriage contract, and he carried it wherever he went. I know it's still here.
I know we've heard at least some of that, but, here, I think I found what you're looking for.
That's it, all right. Law. Still smells like his whiskey, his cigarettes, and that awful cologne he bathed in every morning. Here. I saved up for this, just in case I needed to go out into the ruins myself. Truth be told, I'm glad I never had to use it. You didn't happen to find anything else out there, did you?
Should I tell her the truth? I don't have the heart to tell her the truth. What difference would it make at this point, anyway? I found Jerome. It looks like he died peacefully.
Good. I should have been there for him, but I suppose he wanted to be alone in the end. Thank you for the flask. Jerome and I were supposed to live and die together, but sometimes fate has other plans. Time for me to get off this rock. Memories hang around here like a bad smell, and I could use some fresh air.
This is what he wanted. Go live your life.
That was a real kind thing you did, Captain. Maybe not what I would have wanted, but it looks to be what she needed.
It may seem kinder to not burden people with a complete truth, Captain.
Shush!
But I do not believe that is truly the case.
You're right in front of her. Can't you guys wait? Ignore them. They're talking about something else that we would encountering before. You guys are horrible. Yeah. I'll get down. Oh. Alright. Does she buy everything? I mean,
sorry about Freddy and Trixie. When they're not fighting over salvage, they're fighting over the bed sheets at night.
Those two are a couple? You know, I was kind of wondering about afterwards.
They like to blow off steam during work hours, but as soon as they clock out, they turn into a pair of kittens. So, what'll it be? I'll set them up. You knock them back.
She just want to sell you a bunch of crap. Oh yeah, you will buy my crap. Oh, that's a gun? Medal of Honor? Oh. DPS on that baby. Alright, let's sell this stuff. Medal of Honor. Long guns. So I'll try it out. Thanks. So you have to continue now to the OSI. Well, the OCI. Office of Creative Incubation. Human inquiring audience we can't get into yet. The Chem Lab. I wonder where the Chem Lab is. OCI projector room? Oh, then that thing. The llama. Oh, I have Brave New World as the default. They're all very far away from here, these clues. There's one over here, in the middle of nowhere. Alright, so S- So wait, this is the HIA then. HIA facility we can't get into. And then over here is the Office of Creative Incubation. So then what's... And they're first. The OCI is pretty big. Pretty big deal, right? Security checkpoint. I might want to check what's over here first. Or this. This building. And that's that way. Hi. Yeah, we'll be heading there next. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.